We have already seen that a VLIW instruction really specifies several operations, each of which operations would have taken a normal instruction in a normal superscalar processor. The instruction set for a VLIW processor typically has all the normal ISA opcodes. So each of the VLIW instructions can typically do whatever normal instructions would have been able to do in an out-of-order processor. A typical VLIW processor will also have support for full predication or at least very extensive predication support. This is because it relies on the compiler to expose parallelism. One of the ways the compiler does that is through scheduling instructions, so we really want the compiler to be able to predicate and thus expose more opportunities for instruction scheduling. A VLIW ISA also typically includes a lot of architectural registers. The reason for this is that a lot of the scheduling optimizations require use of additional registers. We have already seen some examples of this in the compiler support for ILP lesson, where we have seen that sometimes we have to put some things in other registers when we are rearranging instructions. So to help the compiler do instruction scheduling, we need more registers than usual, and we really, really want the compiler to do a good job here, so we will provide a lot of registers to it. Another frequently seen type of ISA support for compiler work are the branch hints, where the compiler can specify to the hardware what it thinks the branches will do. This helps the branch predictors. And we also often see some sort of compaction mechanism for VLIW instructions. For example, if we have a for operation instruction, and we have something like this, we do some operation, and then the next operation needs to be here, and thus we have to put NOPs in here. The actual VLIW instruction might include some sort of a stop bit for every instruction, in which case we can put op1 here, then mark this as a stop, and then we can put op2 and op3 like this, mark this as a stop, and even squeeze in maybe something else here. So the idea is that instead of having a lot of NOPs in our instruction, now the processor fetches this instruction, checks for the stop bits, and in the first cycle does this, in the second cycle does up to the next stop, and so on. So this helps a lot in reducing the number of NOPs and thus the code bloat.